this video, we'll be looking at the structure of an artificial neuron. So the artificial neuron is a simple abstraction of a biological neuron. It's supposed to abstract out all the details that actually exist in the biological neuron and just give you whatever is usable. Please do remember that this is a simplification and this is not how actually our brain neurons work. In this video, the topics that we'll be covering are what goes into an artificial neuron and the two operations. Really speaking, both of these operations were things that you had already seen within logistic regression. Okay. We also use these two in logistic regression. We are just going to formally combine these operations into a single thing called an artificial neuron. So let's look at what an artificial neuron looks like in a neural network. So suppose you have some inputs coming in from one end. We can call these biologically, these are supposed to be the equivalent of dendrites. So you have some three variables, in general some vector, x vector, which has these features x1, x2, x3. All these three come in, and as usual, as we did with both linear regression as well as classification, we simply take a linear combination. So we do sigma wi xi, and this component we call z. Remember, the x that comes in is a vector and what comes out of this linear combination z is a scalar. Till this point, what we have here is essentially a linear combination. Now this z goes into the next part, which is the non-linearity, and what makes neural networks work really is this non-linearity. One simple nonlinear function which we have already seen, for example, is the sigmoid function. Graphically, we denote it by the shape of the sigmoid curve. So sigmoid of z would be 1 by 1 plus exponential z. Sorry, minus z, which is the same as so we call this non-linearity in general G. This might be the sigmoid. It could be other functions which we will see later. For example, tan H. We also have another thing called the rectified linear unit or ReLU. So any of these outputs, any of these non-linearities could be used. Now finally, after all this, what comes out is G of Z. This is denoted by A. Also labeled the activation. If this is the only thing in your network, then all you have is your prediction is simply the activation of this neuron, which is G of Z. So remember, the two portions of an artificial neuron are linear combination and an additional non-linearity.